हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फाइव फेसेस ऑफ एपीक्यूपी प्रोसेस। सो डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई हैव ए यूट्यूब चैनल, देयर आर वीडियोज अवेलेबल, सो यू कैन कनेक्ट विद मी थ्रू माई यूट्यूब चैनल टू लर्न मोर एंड मोर अबाउट द टेक्निकल टॉपिक्स। सो डियर फ्रेंड, देयर आर फाइव फेसेस ऑफ एपीक्यूपी प्रोसेस। First phase is planning phase. So planning is for where do we want to go. The second phase is product design and development. In this phase, can we design a new product? Phase 3 is to verify the process design and development of the process, manufacturing process. Can we make a part as per the drawing? And phase 4 is product as well as process validation. So in this phase, we check and confirm before SOP, can we make a product as per the design, as per the plan. And phase 5 is finally, that is the phase of feedback, assessment and corrective action, which is a continuous improvement process after the SOP. So dear friend, this APQP and control plan manual, it graphically represents the process of APQP. So there are various phases. So after completion or after successful completion of the phase, there are several milestones which are to be achieved after successful completion of the each and every phase. So dear friend, if we discuss about the phase 1 of planning, so in this phase we gather or identified various type of inputs which are applicable to the product. Like we collect the technical data, any non-technical requirement also. In this phase we define the product and project goals. We ensure that organization make the key buy decision, the decision which are going to influence the market, and establish timing for deliverable of each APQP element. So during this phase only we decide the timing plan for different phases. Output after this phase, after completion of this phase of planning, outputs are product concept is finalized, which is one of the milestone, and now we have a concept design, or we can say a pre-design is available with us, and concurrent product design and process design can be started as a output from this phase of planning. When we discuss about the second phase, which is product design and development, so output from the phase 1, they are used as input for the phase 2. So in this phase, important activities are carried out, like we do DFMEA, design risk analysis. So during this phase it provides a verified product design, a approved product design, and team commits to product manufacturability. So product design must be as such it can be easily manufactured. Outputs are from this phase, like design record we have bill of material available, and product design is verified and validated, which is another milestone for phase 2 by the design organization. So the team of R&D, the team of engineering, they do design validation also by doing a trial. Now we move to the phase 3. Phase 3 is manufacturing process design and development. So in this phase we create a robust manufacturing process that meets the requirement in term of quality as well as the quantity of the product which is going to be manufactured. So it defines the means to control the manufacturing process and its output. Output from this phase are like process is defined, manufacturing is defined, what is going to be sequence of different processes to make a product, a quality confirmed product. In this phase, establish verified the production readiness review. So that is the milestone C, and we are ready for the validation. Now we move to the fourth phase. Fourth phase is launches the initial production run, or we can say trial production, we can say in another word. So here we collect data to demonstrate that manufacturing and assembly process can produce a conforming product at the required run rate as per the customer requirement. So management determine the process readiness, whether each and every resources are available to enter into a serial production. So by reviewing the result of various trials like product and process design as validated by the organization, production readiness evaluation, corrective action taken for any issue identified during the earlier phases, during the cycle of new product development. So before entering to the SOP, each and every issue is required to be closed before the end of this phase. And in the phase 5, this is the phase where we evaluate if project objectives have been achieved. All the KPI parameters are achieved. Here we record documented records the lesson which were learned during the earlier phases. So we drive a robust production realization process and implement actions to increase the customer satisfaction, to enhance the customer satisfaction. Outputs from this phase are like project goals are achieved, including reliability, quality and customer satisfaction. Other customer requirement is on-time delivery. So all the customer related quality, cost, production and delivery related targets are achieved. That is the output of the phase 5. So dear friend, don't forget to like the video if you found the video useful. So you can connect through me to learn more and more. So my channel name is Ashish Agarwal, Corporate Trainer. Thank you very much.